Australia's new golden generation of Socceroos touch down to a hero's welcome. The seeds of a renewed national passion for soccer take hold.
Federation Square, the Opera House, Amy Park, the support's been unreal. We just want this game to grow. It's a great feeling to know we had such an impact on our Aussies.
I think that's the biggest thing that made us push to want more.
But in a nation gripped by sporting polyamory, the next generation of soccer stars still have to compete with the draw of footy. Yeah! And other footy.
Oh! Graeme Arnold has probably around 200 professionals from which to choose his national team. So if we're serious about this game, if we want to be competitive and win World Cups, then that investment has to come.
While countries like the US pump $41 million into their national team to great success...
And now they're going all out for victory.
The Socceroos put forward the World Cup's fourth cheapest squad, while locally the A-League's $80 million in revenue battles against hundreds of millions from our code behemoths.
We've been homeless since I've been involved for 37 years in the national teams, and we need a home, something like the AIS.
I reckon the entire Australian team wouldn't add up to Lionel Messi's salary.
As the glory fades from their incredible campaign, attention shifts to the 2023 Women's World Cup and our match-fit Matildas.
There's no doubt that the Matildas have got the talent. The Matildas could go even deeper into the women's tournament than the Socceroos have for the men's.
And a bright future ahead for the Socceroos. Substitute superstar Garang Kuol, the youngest knockout stage player since Pele in 1958.
Clips it forward. Garang Kuol on the angle.
So will the Socceroos write a new chapter in the story of the world's game?
One man who'll be central to that new chapter is Socceroos forward Marco Tilio, who joins us now. Hey, Marco, congratulations. Welcome home. Such a huge World Cup effort. How was it?
Yeah, it was amazing just to be involved in my first World Cup. I think it's any footballer's dream. To go to such a prestigious tournament, and for myself to be involved in there, I guess, as I said, it was amazing. And I guess it's one of those things that I think I pinch myself now, and hopefully it can all sink in eventually, because it hasn't really sunk in yet.
Oh, I bet it hasn't. I don't think it's really sunk in for football fans here in Australia. We were transfixed to the Argentina game. What was the mood like in the sheds after we can only describe it as a valiant comeback from Australia?
Yeah, of course, a lot of disappointment in the group. We went back in the sheds and, yeah, we had a few heads down. But I think, as we've always said, the brotherhood and the camaraderie we had in the group was just about bringing each other back up and just really looking back on what an amazing tournament we had. I think we impacted the country and made everyone really proud back home. And I think that's a message at the end of the game that we wanted to send out to each other, because I think we're a bit harsh on ourselves.
Now, Graeme Arnold was really firm about keeping you guys in a bubble, no social media. Now, be honest, how much of the celebrations did you guys see?
I think we've seen most of it. Of course, having that impact on the nation just makes us proud. And obviously seeing all the celebrations back home, I think it just gives you that edge that you need in games. For the team, especially playing every 3 days, if you needed something to pick you up, it's just seeing the nation, how proud they are of you and support back home. So, it was amazing to see that all around Australia, and hopefully we can bring that to our league and the A-League back at home and see all these fans come down to especially the big games like the derbies and stuff like that. It'll be amazing to see all these games, full stadiums, and to just bring the A-League to light.
It's going to have a massive impact, there's no doubt about that. And you got to have a snap with your childhood hero, Lionel Messi. Must be very exciting, but your teammate Cameron Devlin got his shirt. How jealous are you, mate?
Yeah, it was an ongoing conversation, actually. We were going to draw out of a hat whoever's name in the team wants to get the jersey, but then it didn't happen. And then I was rooming with Cammy Devlin, so I was lucky enough to actually have the jersey in my hands after the game. I'm happy for him. He's got the jersey now. I think it's probably the most prestigious jersey you could ever have.
Yeah. And be honest, did he wear it on the plane on the way home or did he sleep in it?
I'm not too sure. It smelt like him, I tell you that, after the game. That's all I can say.
You know, I smell like who, but I don't want the answer to that question. Hey, I can't help but notice you're wearing your Melbourne City shirt. I hear that you had to go to training today, like back at work already. Don't you get it? Aren't you entitled to a day off after all that?
I went back into training this morning. So, it was a short turnaround from getting home last night. And then, we got a game on Saturday, so I'm just trying to prepare myself for that.
Hey, Marco, mate, the squad's still so young. How excited are you about the 2026 Socceroos?
I think you've seen now the quality we have in the team and everyone being so young. You'll see a lot of these boys in the future. And I think the impact, as I said before, we've had on the World Cup this time round, I think it's only going to get better as the years go by. And as these younger players, as we get older, I think we're only going to get better. So we're really looking forward to the 2026 World Cup and hopefully you see a lot of familiar faces in that squad.
Oh, soak it up, Marco. Soak it up because everyone is all around you. Thank you so much for joining us and congrats once again.
Thank you for having me.